The Teachings of Venerable Master Chin Kung.
Buddhism is an education, not a religion. We do not worship the Buddha, we respect him as a teacher. His teachings enable us to leave suffering and attain happiness.
What does Buddha mean? Buddha means enlightenment, understanding. Complete understanding is when one realizes the truth about life and the universe. It is when one is apart from all delusions.
What is purity? Purity is apart from defilement. Defilement is the greed, hatred, and stupidity present in our minds. Cultivation is cleansing these impurities from our hearts.
To keep our mind pure and at peace is like keeping a pond clean and undisturbed. When the water is clear and still, it can reflect the sky, sun, and trees just as they are without distortion. Our mind is the same. When we are polluted by greed, hatred, ignorance, and disturbed by discriminations and attachments, we distort our picture of reality and fail to see things as they are. Wrong perceptions of reality can prevent us from enjoying a clear and happy life.
Learn to turn the light around, reflect upon yourself, and smooth your mind pond still. Everything outside of ourselves are equal in themselves. The garbage does not feel it is unclean, and the flower does not know it is fragrant. There is no such thing as discrimination. We must let our mind be at peace without attachments. This is true happiness.
Don't see the faults of others and don't speak of them. Don't even leave an image of the fault in your mind. The sixth patriarch said,
"True cultivators do not see the faults of living beings."
We should learn to see our own faults.
It would be of great benefit if you can practice the 10 recitation method 9 times a day. Every recitation should not have afflictions, wandering thoughts, or worries. Over a period of time, the power of this practice would be eminent. It can help you reach the pure land.
Cultivation is practiced in our everyday life. We should not see it as something unusual. It is simply changing ourselves for the better.
The first of universal worthy bodhisattvas' 10 great vows is respect. We practice it by purifying our actions, speech, and thoughts. Without purifying these, even if you bow to the Buddha 10,000 times, it is still not considered true respect.
How do we know when our cultivation has improved? The time comes when we begin to understand the sutras deeper, when we can read between the lines and realize the true meaning of the Buddha's teachings. This is when our cultivation has improved.
Is your mind really set on reaching the Pure Land? To want to reach the Western Pure Land is a great wish. We must let go of our worldly affinities and single-mindedly recite Amitabha's name.
To be mindful of the Buddha is to dwell in true wisdom.
The ultimate goal to which all methods of cultivation lead is the complete, pure and equanimous mind. It is our original nature, our Buddha nature.
During Dharma assemblies, we must be sincere when reciting the Putra texts in order to touch the hearts of the attending assembly. The words of the sutra should flow forth from our hearts and not merely spoken. We must truly cultivate. Those who have the ability can just take one look at you and tell you if you're sincere or just putting on a show.
During Dharma assemblies or Buddha recitation sessions, there are always people helping in the kitchen and the Buddha hall. We must know that the merit of these people are the same regardless of where they help out. Never assume that helping in the Buddha hall would be better than elsewhere. Always see things with eyes of equality.
Many people nowadays do not really understand the proper teachings and are not interested either. Their interest lies in repenting past offenses and often come to the way place for that sole purpose. It is our responsibility to explain the proper teachings to them and point out the correct way of cultivation. Only through cultivation can they truly eradicate past offenses, for they will know where they wronged and won't repeat their faults.
To understand the complete teachings thoroughly, one must first cultivate the pure heart. When the pure heart is attained, the teachings would naturally be learned. Without the pure heart, one can study the teachings for 100 years and still won't understand it at all.
Those of you who are interested in explaining sutras in the future must memorize the sutra you plan to lecture, plus its explanation by an authorized teacher. This is the way practiced by all successful lecturers of the past. If he or she is unable to memorize the material and cannot meet the standards, he or she should let go of all their attachments to the world and single-mindedly recite Amitabha's name. There is no need to be upset or feel sorry for not being able to lecture sutras.
In putting the teachings into practice, the first thing we should cultivate is the pure heart. The pure heart is a mind without discrimination or attachments. We must also develop proper understanding by listening to explanations of the Buddha's teachings.
We should treat all people with respect and sincerity. We must be responsible for our actions and careful when handling others' properties. Be conservative with speech and actions to avoid harming others.
Listen more, speak less. Just as a doctor prescribes medicine according to a patient's needs, we must provide teachings which are suitable to the learner's needs. We must consider their capacities, interests, and be able to define the root of their problems. Only in this way can we truly benefit the limitless living beings awaiting us.
The Buddha said before,
"All dharmas arise from the mind."
Our future lies in our hands. If you think of the Buddha constantly, then you will become a Buddha. If you think of bodhisattvas constantly, then you will for sure become a bodhisattva. If all you think about the whole day is the rights and wrongs of others, how to gain more power over others, or just plain scattered thoughts, then your future will definitely be in the three evil paths.
The root of people's sufferings and sicknesses is discrimination and attachment to unrealistic things. The Buddha's teachings tell us how to detach ourselves and not to discriminate. If we listen and practice according to the teachings, we will be at great ease in this world of confusion.
The difference between success and failure of cultivation lies in your learning attitude. Be humble, sincere, and respectful. Don't think you're on top of everything.
The giving practice of the six principles cultivated by bodhisattvas means to let go. We should let go of all our worries and attachments to this world and have faith in this one name of Amitabha. We must be determined to reach the pure land.
When we recite the sixth chapter of the Sutra of Amitabha's Purity, Equality and Understanding in our morning recitations, we are adopting Amitabha's vows as our own. We are extending our hearts and vows broader and broader until they can envelop the entire universe. In our evening recitations of chapters 32 to 37, we reflect within ourselves to see if our actions during the day accorded with the teachings in the sutra. This is the true spirit behind the morning and evening recitations. They are not just something to be done for the sake of doing it.
When we translate Buddhist texts and teachings, we should avoid using terminology so as not to confuse beginners. Translate the essence of the teachings and don't be attached to using the exact words of the original text.
At a place of proper cultivation, the teacher guides the way and fellow students support each other along the way. We should cherish both equally.
We must rely upon fellow cultivators to correct our faults. If we cannot accept criticism from others, we will never reach attainment in our cultivation.
Learn to use time wisely. When dealing with people and matters, be clear of what you're going to do from beginning to end. Don't waste time dawdling around. If time is used wisely, there will be plenty of time left to practice diligence.
When we live together at a place of proper cultivation, we must be mutually respectful as well as harmonious.
The Buddha helps those who have affinity with him. The question of affinity rests in whether the person accepts the teachings or not. The Buddha's compassion and teachings extend over all living beings, just as the sun shines evenly over the great earth. Those who hide in the shade cannot receive the benefits of the sunshine, just as those who cover themselves in ignorance cannot benefit from the Buddha's teachings.
Many people are very energetic in helping others in cultivation when they themselves are still unfamiliar with the Buddha's teachings. We must remember that before helping others, we ourselves must attain a certain level in our own cultivation for the help to be realistic.
Don't be jealous of others. You only harm yourself in the process.
Wisdom is a must if we truly wish to propagate the teachings and benefit living beings. Don't use emotions when helping others. Use wisdom and be reasonable. If we use emotions when dealing with people and matters, it often makes a good thing go bad.
Attainments belong to oneself, not the Buddhas or Bodhisattvas. They do not ask anything from us. They teach us for our sake.
When we read and reread one sutra without tiring, it proves we are capable of accepting the true meaning of the teachings. If you still tire of reciting the same sutra repetitively, it shows that you have not truly benefited from the Buddha's teachings. A mind set on one sutra is cultivating concentration. Wisdom will grow with concentration.
Those who really understand the true meaning of Buddha's teachings are constantly bathed in the Buddha's light.
What is a great kind deed? A great kind deed is the sum of the many small kind deeds we practice every day.
We should constantly be mindful of the people worried by afflictions and bring forth the heart to help them. Learn to tie good affinities with others and always be friendly.
To help others is to help yourself. To respect others is to respect yourself. When we truly cultivate, both our mind and body benefit. We will have less worries and our bodies will be free from illnesses. We will constantly show an expression of contentment and happiness. These are the benefits of true cultivation.